Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Snake Kato and today I'll teach you how to define your own functions. But before we start, what is a function? A function is a group of instructions that execute a specific task. We already know how to use some built-in functions such as print or type, and we will learn many more. But sometimes we need to make our own personalized functions to fill our needs, and it is especially helpful when we need to use it multiple times. To start, we will be using a Python reserved word called def, and the syntax is the following. We write def followed by the function name, the parameter in parentheses, and a colon. Then we can go to the second line, include an indentation, and then tell our function what we want it to do. The indentation can start from one space, but you can do as many spaces as you prefer. In my case, I usually do four. But if you already have Python's language package installed in your Atom's text editor, it would do it automatically for you. And now let's make a function together. We're going to start by using the def word. And also we're gonna create a function titled greet that is gonna say hello to the person whose name is inside the parentheses. Also, always remember to include the colon. Then we press enter and then go to the second line. Here we're gonna tell Python that we want it to print hello. And also the name of the person who is in the parentheses. Remember that this does not run the code. You are just defining a function. And in order to run it, you must invoke it like a normal function. For example, we write greet and we are going to write a name. In my case, snake cut. And now we are going to run our program like we have always done so, by writing Python, then the name of our program and include that py, and we just press enter. As you can see, the computer returned hello snake gato. What if I change this for a different name? For example, Axel. And we save it. And it returns hello Axel. Now, what do you think it will happen if I do this? What if I try to print? And I just save my changes. Why do you think we got none? The reason for this is because we did not include a return value for our function. None indicates that it is empty or that it returns nothing. It is not necessary to include return values in all of your functions. It really depends on what you want to do with your code. The way to include a return value is the following. We are going to define our last function that it's called greet with the name and the colon. And this time, instead of print, we're going to ask the computer to return hello plus the name of the person. Here in hello, I'm going to write a space because if I don't, it is just gonna be hello, for example, snake gato, but all together. Now we can put this in a variable and print the results. For example, I'm going to put it in the variable A that it's going to be greet Axel. And now we're going to ask Python to print our variable A. Remember to save your changes. And we are going to ask Python to run our function. And yay, we got hello, Axel. You can also ask Python to add a little bit of more information in this print function. For example, besides printing A, I'm going to tell it to write, I hope you are paying attention to this video. And let's save it and see how this will work. And remember to include the space here. Hello, Axel. I hope you are paying attention to this video. Let us try a different example. We have to make a function for a restaurant. And we need a function that tells us what the total of the bill is, including a 10% tip. So we are going to define a function named bill that will ask us for a subtotal. And do not forget about the colon. We go to the second line and then create a variable named total. That would be subtotal multiplied by 1.10 because we are including the 10% tip. And now we can ask this function to return the total. Whoops, return total. We are going to create a new variable because we want to know how much did Anna spend in this restaurant. So she spent $10, so let's print Anna's total. Let's save it and let's run our program. 11.0. Now let's imagine that Anna did not go alone to the restaurant and she invited some friends. So let's also add their bills. Now we want to know how much did these three people have to pay to the restaurant. So we write print and we just sum Anna plus 1 plus Sarah, right? We save our file and we run it again. 55. Do you think this is good enough? I don't think so. I mean, if you're the restaurant owner, you may know what it means, but what if your employees don't know what this 55 means? Yeah, it's kind of difficult, right? So what if we make up the print statement a little bit more detailed? For example, the total for table 3 is, and remember, we are using a string here. So that means that what we want is another string, to concatenate another string. So we have to transform these values into a string too. And we include $. And the answer that we get is that the total for table 3 is $55.0. But what if they also want their own bill. So they want to know how much it was for the whole bill, but they also want to pay one by one. Like each one wants to pay their share. So let's change it a little bit. The total for Anna is, here we only erase everything besides Anna and save our file. And now the answer that we get from Python is that the total for table 3 is $55 and the total only for Anna is $11. For your homework, you have to create a function that will calculate the area of a triangle. After you put in the parameters of the values for the base and height. And I hope that this video was useful for you. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. Before I go, I want to mention that this blouse is inspired by the design and iconography from the natives of Chiapas, Mexico. If you want to learn more about these artists and their designs, please enter in the link that I put in the description. See you in the next video! Bye!